Live from the Waldorf Hotel, this week goes dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage for their Strictly This Week Roundup debut, Miranda, She's Lovely, Green, and her partner, Robin Windsor. And put your hands together for the Andy Kite Big Band.
Help! Help! Who can save me from this Brexit madness? This week, we got our first indication of the PM's plans for Brexit. She wants to be the nation's hero and cut us a deal where we have our cake and eat it too. But Germany's Angela Merkel refused to come to Theresa May's rescue. There will be no reciprocal deal for British expats. Looks like the PM and those Brits on the Costa del Sol will have to keep dancing to Europe's tune.
It was absolutely right for us not to do what the Labour Party wanted us to do, which was simply to give away the guarantee for rights of EU citizens here in the UK, because as we've seen, that would have left UK citizens in Europe high and dry.
With Donald Tusk also failing to cooperate on expats, and the City of London warned it won't get a free pass, Theresa might be waiting a while for EU leaders to fall into step.
Clap your hands all together, now the banjo's back in town.
So clap your hands all together, because UKIP's back in town with their new leader, Paul Nuttall.
I've not just talked the talk, I've walked the walk. I've been in the party for 12 years. By far the most experienced candidate. And that's why they've given me the biggest mandate in the history of the party today.
Their latest leader has a plan to take them to the top of the leaderboard by quick-stepping into Labour heartland.
I want to replace the Labour Party and make UKIP the patriotic voice of working people. Is this
the
way
to Amarillo? The Labour Party were in a spin about what to say on immigration, while the Conservatives looked for the way into the hearts of workers, with proposals to crack down on soaring executive pay. It was a little less spangly than people were expecting.
This government is unequivocally and unashamedly pro-business, but we hold business to a high standard in doing so. It's right to ask business to play its part in building an economy that works for everyone. Crying over Amarillo
and Sweet Marie who waits for me. It's a tricky balance. Labour's Clive Lewis thought Theresa May was striking a different tone to that in her conference speech, which was much less effusive about business.
When she launched her leadership, she said she wanted to change in the way, a change in the way that big business is governed. But it seems that there's been a change of mind, Mr. Speaker, because just weeks ago we heard that it wasn't about putting workers on boards, but about finding a model that works for everyone.
Dancing the samba, it's Miranda Green and Robin Windsor.
They call me Cuban Pete. I'm the king of the rumba beat. When I play the maracas, I go tick, tick, boom, tick, tick, boom.
The death of Cuban revolutionary Fidel Castro brought condolences and condemnation from across the world. Jeremy Corbyn's praise for the late dictator raised some eyebrows.
What's so impressive about Cuba is the education and the health services, and I think the legacy of Castro will be that, but will also be this enormous figure on the world stage.
Taking the salsa to new places, it's Miranda and Robin again. Open Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style.
Their stuff at PMQs. Jeremy Corbyn and Theresa May may not be the most nimble-footed orators, but when it comes to the NHS, they have the passion of the salsa.
1.2 million people are lacking the care they need. Why was there not one single penny more for social care in the autumn statement?
But Theresa wasn't going to let herself be wrong-footed. by Jeremy's moves.
At the last election, the Shadow Chancellor, lately of Strictly fame, said local authorities would get not a penny more. Conservatives putting money into the NHS and social care, Labour would deny it.
I don't know who she means, Robin. Do you? Sounds like bad dancing is the way to make a political comeback. We've nailed this.
The judges have their scores.